In those days, a decree went out from the Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken when Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered.
To us, a Savior is born.
Jesus Christ, our Lord. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child.
To us is born a Savior.
Open our hearts to expect your presence among us. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
To us is born a Savior.
Open our hearts to make room for you each day of our lives. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
To us is born a Savior.
Open our hearts and eyes that we may see your glory. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you, and you will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger."
To us is born a Savior.
Open our hearts and lead us to
wrap our lives in the love of Jesus. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors."
To us is born a Savior.
Open our hearts and bring peace to us anew this night. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger.
To us is born a Savior.
Open our hearts and guide us to seek you in all places. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart.
To us is born a Savior.
Open our hearts, we may treasure your word and made flesh among us. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, and it had been told them.
To us is born a Savior.
Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Merry Christmas. Feliz Navidad. Christmasi in Gemma. Bring you greetings of Christmas from all of our partner congregations, our partners in the city of Milwaukee at All People's Church who speak English as we do, our partners at Los Arroyos in El Salvador who speak Spanish, and our partners at Ikeri Parish in Tanzania who speak Swahili. All around the world, we are celebrating the same story this evening. All around the world, we are sharing a story that has been shared for thousands of years. And it's a simple story. And the story goes like this. God came down to us. And that really is the end of the story. But sometimes I think we get lost, because we get lost in all of the words that we try to use to explain what goes on at Christmas time. We get lost in whether we're talking about the story of the Nativity, or is it the birth of the Christ child, or maybe like our text pointed to, some of the many names that Christ has been described by or titled by. And as you'll see on the graphic, Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, Emmanuel, God with us. Whatever the name that we use, they all point to Jesus Christ, who is the center of the story. God coming down to earth to be with us, to experience life as we have experienced life, to live in and among the world around us. God simply wants to be with us. And so sometimes we get caught up in the story. We get caught up in the question of whether Mary rode a donkey from Nazareth to Bethlehem, or if she walked with a group of people. We get caught up in the question of whether Jesus was placed in a wooden box that looked something like this, or if it was a big piece of rock that was cut out of the edge of a cave. We get caught in these questions, and we begin to lose sight of the core of the story. The story, which is simply, God comes down to us, to be among us, to live with us. The Apostle Paul reminds us of this in his letter to Titus, where he says, "For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation to all." In Isaiah's prophecy, he tells of God coming to us. "For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders. He is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." In Luke's telling of the gospel story, it's the angels that get to proclaim the wonderful message. "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people, to all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord." And in response to reciting that text, my favorite theologian of the 20th century, Linus Van Pelt, simply said, "That's what Christmas is all about, Charlie Brown." I think sometimes we complicate the simple message that God comes down to be with us. Christ comes to us wherever we are, wherever we might find ourselves, whoever we might find ourselves to be, whatever baggage we carry with ourselves, Christ comes down to us. Despite the walls that we try to build to protect ourselves or to shelter ourselves, Christ comes to us. And at Christmas, we are reminded of this truth. But we're also reminded that this is not something that just happens on Christmas. This is something that happens every day of our lives. We encounter God in all kinds of ways if we have our eyes open to see God coming down to us. So over the last couple of weeks, as I've talked to different people, I've had conversation and asked the question, how is it that you see God coming to you? How do you see God alive in your life? Here's some of the responses that I got. "Through the eyes of my children, in God's word and in the sacraments of Holy Communion and Holy Baptism, in nature, the colors of a sunset, the growth of a tiny seed into a tree. In the quiet moments. This one is clearly not me, but I think some of you can listen to this one and probably nod your heads. In a perfect cup of coffee. I don't think such a thing exists, but I know some of you will disagree with me. In my marriage, in good deeds done for others and the gratitude that is returned for those deeds, in the work of our police, our firefighters, and our paramedics, in cravings for justice, in those who suffer, the retail clerk who's working on Christmas Eve or Christmas Day. When I set aside my own interest in the interest of others. So my question to you tonight is this. Where do you see God in your life? Where do you see the Christ child coming to you? Maybe this evening you'll find it in the midst of a celebration as you gather later or tomorrow with family or with friends. Maybe you'll find it as you unwrapped a gift and found that it was something that touched you in a very personal and meaningful and special way. Maybe you'll find it in one of the guests around your dinner table. Maybe you'll find it in the laughter of a child who was born so recently that this is the first Christmas that they will experience with you. Maybe you'll find it in a conversation that you have with somebody, thinking that this might be the last time you have conversation with them. Where do you see God in your life? Where do you see the Christ child come into your life? 2,000 years ago, God came to us, Emmanuel, God with us as a tiny baby. And each day, God still comes into our lives. So may this message of Christmas, God with us, be more than just a one-day celebration. May it be more than the donations that we give to favorite charities. May it be more than the gifts that we give and that we receive. But may it be our daily walk, our daily experience with the living God. Amen.